Hi. In this video, I will define biosurfactants and describe the diverse methods to produce them. These production methods include both chemical and biological production processes. I will give some examples for each. First, we will take a look at the sourcing, more specifically the raw materials that can be used for biosurfactant production. According to the definition provided, a bio-based surfactant or biosurfactant is a surfactant that is entirely derived from biomass. Now, if you look at the raw materials shown in this slide, which ones do you think can be used for the production of a biosurfactant? Did you get it right? Natural gas and fossil oil are both fossil resources, which can thus not be regenerated and are thus not renewable. All the other shown options were captured under the umbrella biomass and are also known as renewable substrates. This means that we can keep on producing these, so renew them, in a process where CO2 from the atmosphere is converted by living organisms into biomass, which can then be used as a substrate for the production of a biosurfactant. Now, there are several options to produce biosurfactants. We can mainly make the distinction between either chemical or either biological production routes. Examples of chemical produced biosurfactants are, for example, APGs, SPANs, sucrose, esters, etc. Now, I will first explain two examples of chemically produced biosurfactants, being APGs or alkyl polyglucosides and SPANs or sorbitan esters. For the production of APGs, glucose and fatty alcohols are used, which can, for example, be derived from corn and coconut oil, respectively. These will be added into a chemical reactor, and the reaction will take place at high temperatures, which is thus quite energy intensive, and under acidic conditions. And certain chemical catalysts will be added to enhance the reaction. After the reaction, we will have to go to the purification or downstream processing, which involves the use of organic solvents. We will end up with a product that is already used a lot in, for example, agrochemical applications, but also in detergents. APGs are non-irritant to the skin, which gives them an advantage for use in personal care applications. A second example of a chemically produced biosurfactant are the so-called SPANs, or sorbitan esters. Here also a sugar, in this case sorbitol, which is derived from glucose and thus corn, and fatty acids derived from, for example, sunflower oil, are combined in a chemical reactor again. The reaction takes place at high temperatures and under basic conditions. After purification or downstream processing, which involves the use of organic solvents again, we end up with products that are mainly used in foods. For example, the E number you might see on some of your wrappers of food, the E number E491, which is shown in the figure, is a sorbitan ester which is used as an emulsifier and stabilizer in foods. Now, the second option to produce biosurfactants is through biological production processes. These can be further subdivided into three different ways of production. First, the production by plants. Second, the production by enzymes, so-called biocatalysis. And third, the production through microorganisms by a process that is called fermentation. The last are the so-called microbial biosurfactants. The production of biosurfactants by plants was actually one of the first known uses of humans of surfactants. Certain plants, such as the soaproot plant, were already used 10,000 years ago when we still lived in caves. Rubbing the plant with water against the skin enabled these primitives to wash themselves. And then in terms of going back to the roots, there is actually a renewed interest in these biosurfactants, mainly the so-called saponins. A second example of a biosurfactant produced by plants is cardanol. This surfactant is extracted from the shell of cashew nuts and is used, amongst others, in curing products to produce epoxy floors. Another way to produce biosurfactants through a biological production process is by using enzymes, and thus applying what we call so-called biocatalysis. Although there are very little examples of biosurfactants currently in the markets produced through such methods, so biocatalysis, there is a big interest from the industry to develop such methods and a lot of research in, effort in this respect. You can imagine the production of the chemically produced biosurfactant spans, which I described before, to also be possible through the action of enzymes, which you will then do in a bioreactor. This would have a positive impact on the environmental impact of the production of such biosurfactants. Last but not least, a third biological production method for biosurfactants is by using microorganisms, such as yeasts, fungi, or bacteria, in a process called fermentation. An example are sulfur lipids produced by yeasts. Here, the same types of substrates are used, as was shown before, for the other types of biosurfactants, so for example, sugar and oil, so glucose and, for example, fatty acids. These are now combined in a bioreactor, again, instead of a chemical reactor. And fermentation is a water-based production process. And the catalyst in this case is a so-called biocatalyst. The reaction takes place at low temperature, and in the case of sulfur lipids, this biocatalyst is a yeast. So not the yeast which is used for the production of wine or beer, which you all know, but another type of yeast, which instead of producing alcohol, naturally produces the microbial biosurfactant sulfur lipids. These are already used by several companies in detergent or cosmetic application, for example, as hard surface cleaners. Thanks for your attention and see you next time.